Hey guys, it's Digonto here on Render Lover. In this tutorial, I'm going to explain a few terms on area lighting, and I'm going to use watt over this place and then lumen over these places. In the end, I'm going to show you some post-production how you can achieve your goal and make your exterior render much more better by knowing the values. So this is our model, and I have designed it in SolidWorks and then use texture and label in KeyShot and make it like this. First thing I will do is go to my environment and reduce the brightness. And moreover, I have added a ground plane below so that light can bounce from the ground. Now let's focus on our light source. Say this part is going to be my light source and this specific part is going to be my area light. You can double click and from here you can choose area light, or from your material you can go to light and area light and simply just click and drag it over here. I am going to use this. As soon as you do, you see this part is glowing. Now, if you click here, you will see there are three options: watt, lumen, and lux. From here, you can see that watt is the most powerful, that means hard light, and lux is the soft light. Most usually, lumen and lux is used for interior rendering, but for exterior, we can use lumen sometimes. And here, I'm going to choose watt, and as soon as I do, you see this is the light source area. Now, I'm going to reduce the value. Say like this, this will do my work. On your advanced panel, you'll see there are 5 options. If I uncheck this, then you won't be able to see the back geometry, but the light effect will still be on this place. But if I do the opposite, you won't be able to see the font, that means inside of this bulb, but I cannot show you that. You will see the impact also. If I click both, then the light gets stronger. I don't want to apply in font, I just want it back. So I am going to uncheck it. And then comes visible to camera. If I uncheck this, then you won't be able to see the light source, but the impact will be as usual. See? Okay, then comes visible to reflection. In watt light, it is very hard to show the visible to reflection, but in lux, if there is a reflect in your area, say this part, then it will be showed. I don't want it here. You won't be able to see any difference. And then comes visible in shadow. It means that enable shadow for light source geometry, disable for more accurate result. If there is a shadow in your skin on the area light, then it will be visible. Then comes most important, samples. The sample default is the most accurate value. If you increase the value, then the ray emitting from the source will be increased. And if you decrease, then the ray will be decreased. So default value 9 is a good value that implies all our exterior and interior rendering samples. Next, I want to show you something that will faster your work. If we just click here and then copy this material, and then I'm going to paste it over here. Here you'll find two options: paste link material and paste material. For now, I'm going to use paste material. And now let's come to the first one and change the value. You see, this value gets changed, but this remains the same. So let's undo it, and now let's just copy this, but this time I'm going to use paste link material. Now let's come to the first one and then reduce the value. You see, both of them are affected by this value. So it pass link material will make your work faster. If you don't want these two linked, then simply just click on the part that you don't want to link and then select unlinked material. and then change the value, it won't affect your second one. See, that's how you can work faster in KeyShot. So I'm going to just simply copy those material and paste it to other link material, and it will take some time. After this, let's focus on our lumen light. Say from this part there I will use the lumen light, but the problem is I can't zoom enough. See, it is our minimum distance and you cannot even move your parts. So the solution is very simple. Click on the set camera target and from here you can choose point, model or part. Say we use point here and click on here and then OK. Now I can zoom in and zoom out this specific part and it will work easily. The problem here is that the part is united. So select the part and go to tool and from here use split separate objects. KeyShot will build the mesh inside it and then from here I will choose these two and hold control from the keyboard and then rotate it and again control and click on those two. So I'm going to split objects those and then apply it. Now if I click on this part, you see this part has been splitted. Let's add light over here. As soon as I do, you will see this light. Okay, let's turn the background much more darker. You see, lumen light has been applied to this part. This light is soft and the impact is just a minimum. It's not very much hard like the watt light and it's okay. I want to use it as default value and I don't want to change anything. So I'm just simply just going to copy this to other materials. Now that our lumen and watt light has been applied, we can move forward on our post-processing. For post-processing, go to your lighting and from here choose custom and shadow quality to 3. Now shadow quality 2 to 3 makes it shadow much more clear and much more good to look, and check the ground illumination. It will make the ray bounce from the ground and it will make it much more real. And also check the self shadow. In general lighting, you will find the ray bounce. For exterior rendering, ray bounce from 4 to 7 is the most appropriate value, so I am going to use 6 here. And here I don't need global illumination, it's mostly used for interior to reflect from the wall. And then caustic is only for water or glass materials. In rendering technique, make sure you select product mode, not your interior mode. In our image tab, you'll find two options, basic and photographic. I'm going to use basic here, and in our adjustment tab, you'll find expose and gamma. If we increase the exposure, it will increase the ray from the light source. But I don't want it, I will just make it as default it was. And if I increase the gamma, it will increase the ray bounce. See, so more area will be visible. I'll leave it default as always. Here I'm going to use denoise to make the noise out from here. See, now it's much more clear over this area. And denoiser 8.5 to 1 is the most appropriate value to use. I'm going to leave something like 9.5. In our bloom, if you check on bloom and increase the radius, you will see that this image is going to be blurred and our light sources is going to be much more bigger and much more blurred. You can also increase the density. I'm going to use something like this, not very much clear, not very much blur. Say something like this will do my work. See, now the light source are much more accurate. In our Bignity, if we check here and then change the color to something like this, and then increase it, you'll see that lights comes from all the surrounding of your real-time view. So I will not use it, I will just uncheck it. And in our last step, chromatic aberration, if we check here and then increase the value, you'll see that light got deflected. Let's make it highest 5. See, light is deflected. I don't know what it is said. If you know, please comment below and I'll be grateful for it. I'm going to uncheck it. Before moving to rendering, press H on your keyboard to see the samples, how much time it is taking and how much sample it render on that time. See, I'm going just 3 core, and if I use all core, then you see it takes 6 on 3 minute average. So before rendering, you can always check this, and if we click on render and then in maximum sample, I'll choose above 20. And if you choose above 50, then it's a good choice. Then all your denoise and all your light source will be much more appropriate. And then click on the render. So guys, this is it. This is my tutorial on area lighting technique. If you like it, hit like and subscribe to the channel. And see you again on another tutorial. Until next time, stay connected. Bye.